Good evening, and welcome to tonight's High School Festival Concert. It is with great pride we are here to celebrate our students and appreciate all of the family, friends, and community in attendance. As a reminder, our facilities are tobacco and alcohol free, and our exits are located to the sides and the back of the auditorium. In the event you didn't see it, the Author's Note bookstore is having a book fair outside of the auditorium and will still be available after the concert. Conducting our high school orchestra will be Mr. Paul Monaco. Our high school concert band will be Mr. Jerry Bacon. And our vocal, jazz, and high school chorus will be conducted by Mrs. Kathy Leatherdick. Before we begin the performances, I ask that you please stand for the pledge to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I'd now like to introduce to you Mr. Paul Monaco.
Thank you. I just want to make, well, first of all, welcome back after 2 years. This is the first festival concert in 2 years. The orchestra has their rock concert every other year, and we were supposed to have it last year. So we are making it up this year, which means next year we're going to have another rock concert. So I'm going to find more music. I do it every other year, so each student in the high school orchestra has two opportunities to play this alternate genre, and they learn a lot to be able to go out and play with bands, not just classical, but they go out and play with bands, rock bands, go do studio recording, and we talked a lot about that. For my students in the 5th and 6th grade orchestra, and 7th and 8th, you know that I invited you here tonight, and if you have not received your card, your little extra credit card, come see me at the end of the concert. I'll be hanging out there in the foyer, and I'll make sure you get your card. And then remember, give it back to me on Friday, because Friday grades closed, and I want to raise that grade for you guys. Without further ado, we're going to start off with our first song by Queen, Bohemian Rhapsody.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next song we're going to do for you is by Jimi Hendrix, Purple Haze.
Thank you.
Thank you. Now we're going to go a little bit more modern and do Green Day, 21 Guns. Thank you. Thank you. We have one more piece to play for you this evening, and then the chorus is going to get set up and entertain you, and jazz vocal is as well. The last one we're going to do for you is one of my favorites, and I try to do it every 4 years, so they don't do the same thing. But it's one of my favorites, and it's pretty powerful, and it's Led Zeppelin's Cash. Thank you.
while they're getting up into place, save time, and we'll just zip through our songs. So that's the important part, right? As our, we're gonna announce the soloists for this evening's songs. In our second song, Waters Ripple and Flow, our soloists are Alexis Summers, Deanna Bryant, Allison Berner, and Matthew Pasnick. And in You Will Be Found, we are featuring our senior chorus members, as well as a few of our junior members. So it's a long list. This song, the kids asked me about doing this song. We did this song when those seniors now were freshmen. And they thought about, wow, you know, we missed a lot of concert times. And this song just really resonates with them and with our group. And so they wanted to bring it back. So, our seniors and juniors that are featured in this number, Miles Clark, Gabriella Smith, Brooke Livergood, Jillian Ash, Chelsea Gutierrez, Ella Sy, Nicholas Gutierrez, Ryan Killer, Wyatt Asham, Reed Winslow, Alex Murray, Aiden Migliori, and Emmeline Barani. Okay. So, and I also want to thank our student accompanist, Noah, who has come up and kind of jumped in and come in to accompany us. And it's a great opportunity for him and for us to work with another student in this capacity. So we'd like to thank Noah.
for their second song, two in the middle. You just hit that and it should be queued up. Hey, there you go. Number two. Good. Yeah, we'll just hit the arrow key and it should launch it. Nice job. Holding on lights like a light pro.
And it was,
you are multi-easy.
Easy.
Well, I'm glad you thought so.
Thank you for your patience. Welcome. I think we're going on vacation this evening, starting in Hawaii. We're traveling to Colorado. We're making a stop in California. A little bit of Virginia. Everything has a place. This first piece is, I put this on the program this year because this was the 80th anniversary of the attack on Pearl Harbor this year. And this piece was written specifically about Pearl Harbor. You can hear in this piece the calmness of Pearl Harbor before the attack happened. You can hear the bugle in the morning. You can hear alarm clocks going off. You can hear planes showing up. You can hear the gongs in the steeple of the church chiming seven. And then about halfway through the piece, the attack starts to happen. That goes on for a while. And then at the end, a little bit of a celebration of resolve. So this is F at Dawn They Slept.
Thank you.
Song from the Shenandoah Valley, which is in Virginia. It was on a test yesterday, that's all. And this person that arranged this is Frank Tekeli. Frank Tekeli is a professor of composition at the University of Southern California. He's like a big, big name now in arrangements and compositions in wind band literature, really all over the place. He arranged this, I think about 20 years ago maybe, but since then it's become like a real staple of concert bands like all over the world. We're gonna try something on the back wall is a sight. If you saw the musical, you saw some scenes on the back wall. I found out earlier this year that we can show videos on the back wall while we're playing. So what I did was I called the Shenandoah State Park System and asked them if they had any current videos that they would share with me so I could put some together and show the video on the back wall. And they sent me like this whole hard drive of like time-lapse photography and all this cool stuff. So I had way more that I could use. So I tried to pare it down to a little sampling of everything. So the idea is you watch the Shenandoah Valley while we play Shenandoah, and then you like get all relaxed and stuff. Okay, don't feel like it's cold or anything. Okay, so here it is, Shenandoah.
Thank you.
This next piece, Where the Wild Things Dance. The true confession is I really wasn't sure what it was about when I bought it. I just got it because I liked the name and I liked the song, and it reminded me of the cast party that we have. So I bought it with the idea of people at our school dancing. I then come to find out later that it has to do with the sandhill crane from Colorado, and it's their mating dance. So I shouldn't admit this, but it's a really nice song. Just kind of upbeat, and think of birds, just think of birds. Okay?
Thank you.
there's never a dull moment. There really isn't, the whole day long. So Josh is going to the band room to grab his music that he forgot, so I might talk. So there's these priests. No, I'm just kidding. I would never, please. Okay, this next piece is another one that I picked because I just thought it was spectacular. We were preparing it for our concert that happened right before the whole COVID business started. So we were kind of halfway there to being ready to do it, and I liked it, and everyone liked it, and it was an awesome piece. And then our concert was in 2 weeks, and that was it. So it's been on the shelf for 2 years. So I pulled it out this year, partly because we have fabulous French horns, and this song is full of French horns. So I wanted to sneak it in because I have an old one that likes to play stuff before she leaves. So, Catherine Lee Bates, you all know who that is, right? Some people, yes. 1883, she was an English teacher in Colorado, and her and some of, she teaches at, I think it was the, I don't know, University of Colorado or something. Her and a bunch of her friends decide they're taking a wagon halfway up Pikes Peak, which is in Colorado, and then they get halfway up and they have to take a mule to the top of Pikes Peak. So this is like a pretty much an all-day affair. So this Catherine Lee Bates gets to the top of Pikes Peak, and she is so inspired by the view that as soon as she gets down to the bottom of the mountain, she writes a poem, and the poem is the words for America the Beautiful. And after a while, they found a song from an organist in New Jersey. And this song comes together, and they change the words a little bit here and there. But basically, there's like three versions, and it's the third version that everybody knows. And there's other verses that nobody knows. But she wrote this very extensive poem that's very nice. So the arranger of this piece took that, and he... The idea was that he wrote this piece in the eyes of a hiker who starts at the bottom of the hill and works his way up through the easy stuff and gets up to the high stuff and finally gets to the summit of the mountain and is overtaken. And all through the song are these little pieces of America the Beautiful that are thrown in. Some of them you'll hear right away, but other ones, if you study the score, there's like these little pieces that happen all over, and it's like super, super cool. So this is Pike's Peak. The original plan, long enough, thank you. The original plan actually is I have a bunch of footage that I was gonna show for this one too, and then I thought, no, I'm not gonna overdo it. I kinda wanted you to get out the pieces of this without the visual stuff. So as long as you don't get sleepy, you can close your eyes and just visualize this take up. What's that? Cool. Ouch. So, Calvin, here we go. I hope you're well rested. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. Safe travels home.
Button on the side, right?